the Mayo Brothers, founding the legacy of Mayo Clinic. In 1889, Drs. William and Charles Mayo and their father, Dr. William Worrell Mayo, founded St. Mary's Hospital, which would eventually become part of the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. The Mayo brothers were leaders because they established the first team of doctors to work together in one building, and they had a strong dedication to education and research. They left a legacy because they successfully developed new surgical techniques still used today, and they created the first non-profit hospital. Now, from the beginning. In 1819, William Worrell Mayo was born in England. He went to medical school and then decided to move to New York City in 1845. He later moved to Rochester, Minnesota and started a medical practice in 1864. Dr. Mayo and his wife, Louise, had two sons, William, born in 1861, and Charles, born in 1865. They taught their sons about medicine and anatomy very well. Therefore, it is not surprising that both boys became doctors. Our father taught us to be doctors the way farm boys are taught to be farmers, they frequently stated. They later became known as Dr. Will and Dr. Charlie, or, when referred to together, the Mayo brothers. In the mid-1800s, there was not very much total medical knowledge, a small enough amount so that one doctor could know all of it. Therefore, doctors only worked individually and never in a group. However, in the 1880s, when the Mayo brothers finished medical school, the total amount of medical knowledge was increasing greatly. There was now too much for one doctor alone to know. A collaboration of doctors was needed. The Mayo brothers were leaders partially because they organized and worked as part of the first team of doctors in the world. But what did the brothers practice and how was it founded? On August 21st, 1883, a tornado struck Rochester, destroying a third of the town. 44 people died and over 200 were injured. This was before Rochester had a hospital. The Mayo doctors set up a makeshift care unit in Rochester's dance hall, with the Sisters of St. Francis as nurses. This tornado made Rochester realize how much they needed a hospital. Mother Alfred Mose, head of the sisters, talked to Dr. Mayo Sr. about starting one in Rochester. They agreed that, if the nuns could raise enough money to build a hospital, the three Mayos would be its doctors and the nuns would be its nurses. The nuns raised enough money, so on September 30th, 1889, with 27 beds, St. Mary's Hospital opened. St. Mary's Hospital was run by the Mayo doctors, but it was not the Mayo Clinic. The Mayo Clinic was a separate organization that opened in the 1910s. Its first building was the first one in the world designed specifically for multiple doctors. Recall that the idea of doctors working together did not come until the 1880s, when medical knowledge was growing and one doctor could no longer know everything about medicine. This was also coincidentally when the Mayo brothers were young doctors. They formed the first ever collaboration of doctors, and therefore the first ever clinic. St. Mary's Hospital eventually became part of the Mayo Clinic. The Mayo brothers were hugely dedicated to education and research. Every year, each of them would visit a medical organization somewhere in the world. They made sure that on every trip they brought back a new technique or item that they could incorporate into their practice. They each wrote at least 6 articles for medical journals per year. They always let other doctors watch them do surgeries, and they admitted and explained any mistake they made in order to advance the education of other doctors. The Mayo brothers also started the Mayo Graduate School of Medicine, the world's first graduate program for doctors. In the early days of St. Mary's Hospital, Dr. Will and Dr. Charlie used it only for surgeries. Therefore, they were able to develop many new surgical advances taken for granted today. The Mayos were able to diagnose conditions and illnesses that other doctors couldn't, and they created new surgeries to cure them. Dr. Charlie invented new surgical instruments still used today, but the biggest surgical progression that the Mayo brothers accomplished was enforcing the use of sterilization during surgery. Before the Mayos, surgeries were full of germs and patients would constantly become infected. The Mayo brothers made sure that surgeries were always as germ-free as possible. Can you imagine a world today without surgical sterilization? Probably not. Luckily, you don't have to, thanks to the Mayo brothers. The Mayo Clinic was the first non-profit hospital. From the beginning, Dr. Will and Dr. Charlie always set aside half of their earnings to be used only for the advancement of the hospital. As Mayo Clinic grew, whatever money not needed for salaries or equipment went into a bank account called an endowment fund to help the clinic. In 1919, they added their houses and other property to the endowment fund and called it the Mayo Properties Association, now known as the Mayo Foundation. After this, the Mayo brothers did not own the Mayo Clinic anymore. The endowment fund did. The Mayo Clinic treated every patient, regardless of their ability to pay. Poor people sometimes didn't need to pay at all. This was how a non-profit hospital worked. Nicole Babcock, historical archive specialist at the Mayo Clinic, thinks the most fascinating thing about the Mayo brothers was
the way that they complemented one another. The brothers made decisions about the clinic together, but since Dr. Will had administrative ability, he took on this role. Since Dr. Charlie was a people person, he would help to smooth over hurt feelings. Despite such personality differences, the brothers seemed to understand each other very well and were extremely close.
When asked how the Mayo brothers' legacy lives on at the Mayo Clinic today, Babcock says,
"The Mayo's legacy is carried on by putting the needs of the patient first. No matter what job a person has at Mayo, they are always urged to consider how their job impacts the patient and what they can do to make the patient's experience better."
Although that legacy is still strong today, the Mayo brothers didn't last forever. Dr. Charlie died in 1939, when he was 73. Dr. Will passed only a few months later, at age 78. They certainly left a legacy for their clinic. It continued to make many notable and significant discoveries and advances. Probably the most significant one was the discovery of cortisone in 1950, a hormone known for its ability to reduce swelling. The doctors who discovered it won the Nobel Prize. Their clinic was also the first to use a heart-lung bypass machine during open-heart surgery in 1955. They were the first to perform an artificial hip replacement in 1969. Another huge advancement by the Mayo Clinic was the introduction of a CT scanner in 1973. All of these things are taken for granted today and used daily worldwide. The majority of hospitals today are non-profit. The Mayo brothers started this. All hospitals worldwide today are run by a group of doctors. The Mayo brothers started this too. They were the best known doctors in Minnesota's history. Their teamwork was unbelievable. They always referred to themselves as my brother and I, even when discussing individual achievements. One person even told them, "Your greatest success was not as doctors, but as brothers." They founded the Mayo Clinic, and with the help of Dr. Mayo Sr., they became the greatest doctors ever in Minnesota, and two of the greatest doctors ever in America. In 2014, Mayo Clinic celebrated 150 years since Dr. Mayo Sr. started his original medical practice, the earliest form of Mayo Clinic. It continues to be one of the greatest hospitals in the world, with campuses in Florida and Arizona, as well as Minnesota. The clinic cares for more than 1 million people each year. As Cheryl Smeal, a 20-year nurse in St. Mary's Thoracic Unit, says,
"The Mayo model of care is everywhere. It is embedded within our culture of service. The needs of the patient come first. This drives what we do as a bedside nurse. It drives research, development, brainstorming, everything. It is frequently referenced when discussing issues or changes that are occurring within the institution. Even when it is not actively being discussed, it is just the undercurrent of who we are."
Overall, the Mayo brothers were powerful leaders in medical history. They organized the first ever team of doctors, and they had a strong dedication to education and research. They certainly left a legacy by creating the first non-profit hospital and successfully developing new surgical techniques taken for granted today. Their Mayo Clinic continues to make medical advances and perform excellently. Their legacy remains strong, and it will always be remembered as possibly the greatest team of doctors ever.